In this video, I'm going to show you how to make a cool interactive floor plan on Home Assistant. Make sure you stick around, and if you like what you see, make sure you hit subscribe below and keep an eye out for more videos. Hi, I'm Will from Will Surridge Tech, and today we're going to create an awesome floor plan for your Home Assistant setup. We're going to start off by making a demo floor plan in SweetHome 3D and exporting various graphics to display when lights are on and off. We're then going to integrate it into Home Assistant, adding buttons to operate your lights, your music and your heating, each with a pop-up for finer control. There are loads of really cool examples out there for floor plans on Home Assistant, but a lot of them look a bit busy for me. I wanted a very simple layout where I can see a basic overview of my home, and I'm not clogged up with lots of numbers and figures and sensors. If I want to find out more information, then I want to be able to click on it and get the information there. A lot of the code you'll see today is from Luke Vink. He's got a short video on YouTube demonstrating the full capabilities of his Lovelace. That and his GitHub are linked below. I have also made a GitHub repository for all the code that I make during these videos. So if you want to see the final version of this floor plan, slightly neatened up, you can find it there. Now as a bonus, if you stick around till the end, I'm going to show you how you can force your Lovelace to refresh every time you make an edit. But first, let's make a floor plan. If you haven't already, you need to download and install SweetHome 3D. The link's in the description below if you need it. Once you've got it, open and create a new floor plan. I'm going to make a simple two-room apartment for the purposes of this, but you can add extra floors or make it as complicated as you like. We're going to start off by making the four walls for each room, and then we need to create a room. So we click on Create Rooms, and then we double-click inside each of the two rooms. On the left, at the top, we have a library of all the items that we can use in our floor plan. And at the bottom, we have a list of all the items that are in our floor plan already. We're going to start off by adding some doors and windows, and then we're going to fill it out with furniture. You can change the size of your furniture using the corners or by changing the width, height and depth in the list at the bottom. You also can change the elevation. This might be useful if you're placing things like bedside lights on bedside tables so they're not poking up through the bottom. After that, we're going to add some lights. Now this is really important for when it comes to exporting our images later. I'm going to change the colour of the walls, the floor and add a skirting board now. And then we can head over to our 3D view. Once here, we want to rearrange it so it fills the screen as much as possible and it's in the orientation that we want it to be in. Once we're happy with it, we can right click and store point of view. This enables us to recall this view so all our pictures will line up when we export them later. To make our daytime photo work, we need to tell SweetHome where the house is and which direction it's pointing in. So we go back to the 2D plan, right click and click modify compass. Here we can enter the lat and long of the house and the compass direction. Now we need to turn all the lights off for our daytime photo. So we go to the list in the left and click on each one, setting the light power to 0%. Once we've done this, we're ready to export our photo. So we go back to the 3D view, right click, go to point of view and recall the saved point of view you made earlier. Now we can right click and click create photo. First up, we need to change our size. I'd suggest making the width 1920 and then the height will automatically adjust. But if you're going to use a larger screen, you may want to increase the pixel count here. Next, we change the quality to best, we change the time to midday, and we uncheck add ceiling lights. Now we can click create and it will render our photo. This may take a while, but once it's done, click save and save it in a suitable location. Now we're ready to create our nighttime image, but we need to add a little bit of light, otherwise it's just black. So we're going to go to our two ceiling lights and turn them to about 15%. You may find you need them a bit brighter if you've got a bigger space. Now we repeat the same process for exporting the photo. We right click, go to point of view, click on our save point of view, then we right click again, click create photo, but this time we're changing the daytime to nighttime, so we set the time to midnight. We click create, we let it render and then we save it in a suitable location. Now we're ready to create the photos for all our other lights, but first we need to turn off the two ceiling lights. Then we select our other light and set it to 100% brightness. Now we can create photo in the same way. We make sure we're in the right view and then we click create photo. We want the time to be midnight for this. We click render, let it render, and then save it in a suitable location. We can now repeat this for all our other lights. You might find that some of the lights are too bright at 100%, so you can always set them lower. This might be the case for an LED strip or some accent lighting that you have. Now you want this brightness to be as bright as your lights usually are in your home, so you can get as much of a realistic impression as you can. Once we've got all the photos for our different lights, we need to transfer them over to Home Assistant. I'm just going to use my normal file browser to do this over the network, but you can also use the online file editor if you prefer. Now we need to head into Lovelace. As per usual, I'm going to reference an external file here, but you can just do it at the bottom of your Lovelace if you prefer. In our new view, we need to add a title, an icon, and a path, as you would normally. The first card we're going to use is the config template card. This enables us to use JavaScript to access the colour of the lights, so we can then use that to edit the photos later on. Now we're going to add a picture elements card. This is going to be our nighttime view and our base layer. Next up, we need to add some conditional cards. The first one being a daytime photo. Now this one uses the sun opacity sensor to determine how much it needs to brighten our nighttime photo by to make it realistic in the daytime. Make sure you add the sun opacity sensor into your config file. You're also going to need a transparent image. You can find one of these on my GitHub. Next up, we need to add all the photos for our light entities. This is a similar process as before, except instead of using the sun, we're using the light and its colour and brightness to determine the effect on the photos. Unfortunately, this only works for fully coloured bulbs, displaying an HS value, and not just colour temperature bulbs. Now we need to make sure we rename any entity that is listed to the correct one, and change the file path for the image that we want to display. Now we can repeat this for all the bulbs we have. If you made sure you were referring back to the save view when you're exporting your photos, then all these images should line up perfectly. If you have a really big floor plan, then you may wish to use a photo editor to delete the parts of the image that are irrelevant for that particular bulb. For example, rooms that aren't the room that the bulb is in. This will speed up the process of loading each image when you change the state of the light bulb. What you need to do is make sure that the overall image size remains the same. Once we've done all this, we can head over to our Lovelace and we should be able to see our floor plan. Now this will respond to the sun and will respond to the light, but we want to make it interactive. So let's add some buttons. Now in this video, I'm going to use the full code, but in the final version linked below, you'll see that I'm using decluttering templates to simplify things and make them a bit easier to read. For each light, we need to copy and paste this bit of code, changing the entity, the title, and the left and the top percentages. Now this is the percentage of the image from the left and the top that we want our button to appear. You can get an add-on tool to tell you exactly what this number needs to be, or you can just use trial and error. Once we're happy, we can go over to our floor plan and test it out. We should see that some circles have appeared. If we tap them, they will toggle the light on and off, and if we hold them, it will pop up with a little window, giving us the ability to change the brightness, the colour temperature, or indeed the colour. You may notice that some of the colours have gone a bit weird when you change the colour of a coloured bulb. That's because of the way the colour filtering works. It will actually rotate the colour of the entire image on the colour wheel by a certain number of degrees. This means that the effects are so much more dramatic than they would be in real life. Now that's great, but let's add something else. Let's add some media players. This is the same principle as before, except we're going to have an icon this time so we know it's not a light. We're going to change the entity, the top, the left, and the title. This time for the tap action, we want it to call service, a media player, play or pause. We also want to change the hold action, no point displaying the brightness of a speaker. So instead we're going to use the mini media player. This is a great card available in the hack store, and it provides the ability to group or ungroup speakers and a row of custom buttons where you can preset and predefine some playlists or some stations. Once we're happy, we save it and let's go check it out in Lovelace. The last thing we're going to add is heating. Now this isn't the tidiest solution, I'll admit, and it does have some refresh problems, but it's the best I could find. What we're going to use is an image element, so we need to make sure we're at the bottom of our Lovelace, so these images appear on top of all the background images. We've got two images for two different states. We've got a white rectangle, or a grey rectangle for when the radiators are off, and a red rectangle for when the radiators are on. For this to work, we need to use a template sensor to extract the heating information from our climate entity. When the heating is off, we display an off image. When the heating is on, we display an on image. Now when we tap it, it brings up a thermostat card so we can control our heating further. And there we go. We have an overview of our entire house. At just a glance, we can see whether the heating's on or lights are left on. With a tap, we can control our music, our heating, and our lighting. Now, obviously, this could be so much more powerful if you want to integrate other sensors. You could use motion sensors or cameras, or even tell you what's playing on the TV. I said I'd show you how to make sure your Lovelace refreshes every time you make an edit, so here we go. Some of you might be thinking that happens anyway, what is he talking about? And that may be the case for you, but others of you, if you're like me, have spent hours and hours refreshing a page wondering whether it's actually refreshed or not. The key thing here is if you edit your Lovelace in subfiles like I do. It turns out that Lovelace will only force a refresh if the UI-Lovelace file has been edited, and not if any of the subfiles have been edited. So the workaround here is to have another tab open with your UI-Lovelace file. That means when you're editing your subfile, you can also make an edit in your UI-Lovelace file. This can be as simple as just pressing enter and backspace if you like, but make sure you save it. Then when you go into your user interface, it'll force a reset. And there we go, we've built an entire floor plan. Now remember to check out the compact code below so you can give it a go for yourself. Make sure you hit subscribe so you can find out more about my tech and how you can build yourself the ultimate smart home.